When you say, you know what are direct expenses already, for our quick reference, I have the list here. Now, that is your direct expense. Now, the remaining would be your indirect expenses. At the same time, you also know that most of the indirect expenses fall into category of three major heads. You can say one is office and administrative expenses, office and administrative expenses, and the another category is selling and distribution expenses, selling and distribution expenses. Then we can say remaining as others, the ones which neither are related to office nor related to selling and distribution. Now, we generally have the items like salaries, office rent, rates and taxes. The list is given in your page, a model profit and loss account on page 223. On page 223, quickly refer and we will run through the items that are your office and administrative expenses, similarly selling and distribution and others or financial expenses, what it is given as. So it's stated that under office and administrative, you have salaries, rent, insurance, printing and stationery, audit expenses, legal charges, general expenses, repairs, etc. Now, in selling and distribution, you have your carriage outward, advertisement expenses, bank charges, commission, bad debts, and packing expenses, etc. Then in the financial expenses, you have discounts, interest, etc., interest on capital, interest on loan, etc. Coming to the credit side, generally we have gross profit coming from trading account, we write gross profit brought down, and if it is a gross loss, we write it on the opposite side. Then some examples of indirect incomes are given on the credit side. They are discount received, interest received, commission received, rent received, dividends received, etc. Now, and one more thing is, you have your something called there by bad debts recovered. Bad debts recovered. Now, what is recovery of this bad debts? Now, what is a bad debt? Bad debt is related to credit sales. Now, what is credit sale? Credit sale is when you sell goods on credit and you expect your customers will give that money on a later date. Now, when the customers do not pay, and there is no possibility of you, not able to receive them, and when there is possibility that you cannot get them, then in such a case, we refer the amounts that are not received as bad debts. Suppose suddenly this customers, some of the customers come and give you money, then you can say, okay, when you receive the amounts, receive the amounts towards bad debts, that is your customers coming and paying the money after you considered it as a loss in the previous year. Suddenly this year they come and pay you money, that is referred as bad debts recovered. So previous year you have treated a revenue as a loss because you did not get money. Now suddenly that loss has been recovered again, we treat it as an income, and bad debts recovered is an income. So these are some of the indirect expenses and incomes that would appear in your P&L account, because they all fall under the category of nominal accounts. So, because P&L account is a nominal account, that is On the debit side, we show all the expenses. On debit side, we show the all the expenses. On the credit side, we show indirect revenues. So that is how you prepare your P&L account.